has.
Silent in the chill of midnight.
bells ring, and softly church choir sings. It's the song of praise, the ancient of days, when hope was born this night. There are angels in this place, and my heart resounds with the praise. Like a shepherd so scared, I'll rejoice and declare that hope was born this night.
Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill toward men. Let all of the world sing a chorus of joy, because hope was born this night.
Thank you. Good afternoon and Merry Christmas. Please stand.
Welcome to all those who are joining us via live stream, all those who are with us maybe for the first time, or maybe you haven't been back to church in a few months because of the COVID, but it's good for us to be here to celebrate the birthday of our Savior. Let us pause, and before we enter into these sacred mysteries, be mindful of the times we have failed, and let us seek the Lord's mercy and forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came that we might have life eternal. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And you plead for us at the Father's right hand in heaven. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you.
God, who have made this most sacred night radiant with the splendor of the true light, grant, we pray, that we who have known the mysteries of the light, of His light on earth, may also delight in His gladness in heaven, who lives and reigns with You in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, and they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son given us. Upon his shoulder dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful, from David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Today is born our Savior, Christ the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus. Beloved, the grace of God has appeared, saving all and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and to live temperately, justly, and devoutly in his age, as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to deliver us from all lawlessness and to cleanse for himself a people as his own, eager to do what is good. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went out to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph, too, went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, that is called Bethlehem, because he was the house and the family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region, living in the fields and keeping watch by night over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim good news to you of great joy that will be for all the people. For today, in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Christ and Lord, and this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, and praising God, saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Tang, Merry Christmas. Now sit down. Of course, Tang is one of our seminarians. He's from Vietnam, and of course, I've been teaching him a little American. So I taught him how to say Merry Christmas. Anyway, it is a good time to be together. Despite the rain outside, despite the pandemic, despite the fact that we can't sit close together, despite the fact that we have to wear masks, and I can't tell who is sticking their tongue out at me right now. The ones who didn't laugh are sticking your tongue out at me. I know it. You know, there is this sense we hear from our first reading. you know, those who walk in darkness. You know, this past year has been some sort of darkness for us with the pandemic, a lot of uncertainty. But then there is this light. There is this vaccine that's out there. And there is light at the end of the tunnel, so to speak. And that's why it's so nice to hear this gospel passage today. The gospel which tells us of the nativity of Jesus Christ, the birth of our Savior. It gives us hope. It tells us to forget about the darkness and look into the light and see Jesus. And like a lot of people of a certain age, my own, everyone who's about 30 to 35, you know, the first time we heard this gospel passage was probably not at church. It was really as we were in our parents' living rooms and we were watching a Charlie Brown Christmas. And it was not by a preacher or a priest or a deacon, which was proclaimed it, but by a little boy. And that little boy's name was? Linus. What was his last name? You don't know Linus's last name? Linus Van Pelt. He was a great philosopher. And he was the first one to tell us this beautiful story. And ironically, a lot of us don't realize the importance that that show had at the time. And matter of fact, even now, there's a lot of importance. Charles Schulz, the creator of Peanuts and the one who wanted to have this put on CBS, met with a lot of difficulty. The executives were nervous. They were nervous about not having a laugh track. You know, it's always important to let people know when it's time to laugh. They were nervous about using real children's voices for the children's voice, for the children in the show. And they were really nervous about having that piece of scripture included. Forbid you should use scripture to tell the story of Jesus' birth. You know? But Charles Schulz stuck to his guns. And the result is that we have one of the television's most prized and beloved Christmas specials. And over the years, they say about 40 million people watch that show annually. It's humbling to remind those of us who climb into the pulpit every week, sometimes the most powerful pulpit really isn't a pulpit at all. And often the most effective preacher isn't exactly a preacher. What is it about St. Luke's telling of the nativity that makes it so endearing and enduring? Year after year, century after century, whether on television or in church, we're drawn to this story and moved by it again and again. It is, for so many of us, the Christmas story. And part of the reason is the cast of characters that St. Luke assembles in the story. St. Luke was the only evangelist who was not a Jew. He was not Jewish. And his gospel was beautifully inclusive. He is the evangelist for the outsider, the outcast, and so is the birth narrative we just heard. It is a narrative for everyone. We have Jesus and Mary and Joseph, the shepherds, the angels. We even hear Caesar Augustus appear in the story. The only ones who are not mentioned in this story are the wise men, but they're on their way. And they'll get their own holiday or their own special day in a few weeks. But in this narrative, we see the world spread before us and reminds us that everyone is welcome in the midst of Jesus. Everyone is welcome to the stable. And beyond the setting and the sentiment, there is a truth here that strikes at the heart of every believing Christian, that truth that defines Christmas. It is there in the middle of the gospel, the very first words that are spoken. And it's kind of odd when Linus Van Pelt shared with us this story of Jesus' birth, it was the only time he dropped his blanket. Whenever we saw Linus in Peanuts, he had that blanket, his security blanket. And it was the only time we see him drop it is when he's reading or proclaiming that gospel. And he says, "Do not be afraid." And at that very moment, he drops it. Go home, look it up on YouTube. It's really inspiring if you watch it. Do not be afraid. And then it gets better. Behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. A Savior has been born for you who is Christ and Lord. And whether we know it or not, whether you express it or not, deep down inside, in your gut, these are the words we have been longing for. With this moment, the course of human history changes forever. God becomes one of us. The Savior's very name proclaims that incredible truth that no one ever thought possible. Emmanuel, God is with us. It's a stunning thought, and it's almost overwhelming if you think about it. And it's not that God has become one of us in our image, in our likeness. No, God has become one of us that we may assume that image and likeness in which he made us. God has become one of us so that we can become more like him. Do not be afraid. Across 2,000 years, those words reach out to us in joy and hope and consolation. No matter who you are, no matter where you live, no matter what your circumstance, this is what matters. Do not be afraid. And there's so many things in life that we are afraid of, so many things that we cling on to with our security blanket. And Jesus is saying, don't be afraid. Trust in me. But even in the darkest of nights, there is light. A Savior has been born for you, who is Christ our Lord. This is our hope. He didn't come in grandeur and majesty. He didn't come to intimidate or frighten or bully us. He came as the most helpless and dependent of all creatures, a baby in a manger in Bethlehem, a place where animals eat. And he continues to come to us. The neat thing is, if God can make this possible, imagine what other miracles he has in store for each and every one of us, if we only trust him and we're not afraid. So on this evening, as we continue to proclaim the good news of great joy that will be for all people, we have to remember a Savior has been born for us, and he continues to be born in our hearts if we only allow it to happen. That, I think, is the great power of Christmas. The reason why year after year, that beautiful passage from Luke, which many of us heard for the first time on television watching Charlie Brown, it still resonates. Christmas is about redemption, yes, but we need to remember that that includes God's overpowering love for us, his reassurance of a troubled, frightened, sometimes cold world, that he is with us throughout everything. He dreams with us, he struggles with us, he grieves with us, and he hopes with us. We need to remember his name, Emmanuel. God is with us. So we need to remember the words of the angel, do not be afraid. And that's why I love at the very end of Linus's monologue, when he turns to Charlie Brown and says, that's what Christmas is all about, Charlie Brown. Let us stand. And let us bring before our Heavenly Father our needs this day. As we celebrate the birth of Jesus, we rejoice in the goodness of God. With trust, we present our needs to our Heavenly Father, that the church may joyfully proclaim the birth of our Savior and transform the world through word and deed, we pray. And that bishops, priests, and deacons who guide God's people may be faithful heralds of the good news of salvation, we pray. For peace in the world, that nations may resolve their conflicts by giving themselves over to Christ, the Prince of Peace, we pray. That all those who are away from their loved ones this day, may they be filled with Christmas peace and joy, we pray. For those serving in the armed forces and law enforcement, emergency responders, for all those in healthcare, for the continued growth of peace and freedom in troubled parts of our world, we pray. That the sick and the lonely may enjoy the consolation of the presence of love and family, of love, presence and love of family, friends, and a wider Christian community, we pray. For all those who pass from this life, may they be welcomed into the life that never ends, we pray. For the parishioners of St. Ursula's Catholic community, we pray. Father, we praise you with joy for having sent your Son into the world. Give us grace to be faithful to the gospel we profess. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. stand and pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May the oblation of this day's feast be pleasing to you, O Lord, we pray, that through this most holy exchange we may be found in the likeness of Christ, in whom our nature is united to you, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in a love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing to him of your glorious without end, we acclaim. Created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to the glory of your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke the bread. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, with Saint Ursula, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, advance the peace and salvation of the world, O Lord. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, William, our Archbishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your very own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your people, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your divine will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold, the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. How blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Angels breathe through.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, that we who are gladdened by participation in the feast of our Redeemer's Nativity may, through an honorable way of life, become worthy of union with him who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Once again, I do want to wish you all Merry Christmas. Thank you. And I do pray for you in the new year and pray for each other in a quick turnaround from the pandemic. And if you have any questions about that, with the vaccine that's coming out, just go and watch the movie Legend. Go watch it. You'll know what I'm talking about. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May this is ended. Go in peace. Thanks be to God. And together we say, St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.